tremendous experience. We bring almost 1 million guests a year. They love coming here, and we feel very honored and privileged to be able to bring them here to enjoy all the great things here in Cayman. In this particular port project, which in a way is historic, I guess, with this referendum, I'm not sure there's been a referendum like that ever in the past, and so it's a historic thing. But for us, it's important that we fit in with the will of the locals, and that we are guests, and we bring guests here. So there's two mantras in our business. The first is happy crew, happy guests. And second and equal, happy locals, happy guests. So our guests don't want to go someplace where they're not welcome, and we certainly want to introduce them into that. But they've always been welcome here, and we've had a 40-year history here in the Cayman, and we're excited about it. So our vision is to bring in a sustainable fashion more guests to Cayman to help drive the local economy and to expose, people to all the beauty and wonder and experience that is here in Cayman. The challenge with some of the much larger ships is that they don't tender anywhere in the world. And the reason is just because of the flow of the guests on the ship. You have, some cases, many more thousands of guests, and a tendering operation can become quite tedious. And in our business, happy guests, happy crew, and guests in a long queue does not make for happy guests. So there's, practically speaking, just certain size ships that it's not practical to tender. But there will always be, some tender capacity required, because there's all types of sizes of ships. Within our 9 brands, we have ships, new ships even, with as few people as 200 on them or 600 guests. And we have some that have 6,600 guests. And so there's a full range. But to have Cayman have the opportunity to continue to grow, some of these larger ships are going to be in the Caribbean. They're going to be on great Caribbean itineraries, and Cayman will want to be part of that.
What kinds of jobs would the port project offer that aren't already in existence here?
Well, I think there will obviously be in the construction aspect of it all. There will be a number of jobs, created because it's new construction, so it's new work. So it will be hundreds of jobs, created within that context. Hopefully, as you bring additional guests in, it will also cause growth. And we talked about additional excursion opportunities and different ways to experience the Cayman Islands. It will create additional jobs in that. And also, with the additional volume, additional job opportunities within sectors that already are benefiting today. So all of those, and then you have the economic multiplier effect from provisioning to crafts and ships to transportation on the island, et cetera. So that whole economic multiplier effect. What I do know is that typically one job on a cruise ship creates 5 to 7 additional jobs, in an economy. And so that's the latent opportunity for continuing to responsibly grow the cruise industry here in Cayman. For our highest responsibility, and therefore our top priority, is excellence in safety, in environmental protection, and in compliance. And those are not just words. Not only is it the right thing to do, but if you think about our business, if we aren't safe, then people aren't going to sail with us. No one wants to go to a location where they can't breathe the air, that the water is polluted, that it's soiled and unkempt. No one wants to do that. And so it's not only the right thing to do from a societal standpoint, it is absolutely required for our business. So it is our highest responsibility and one of our top priorities. Does that mean we never make mistakes? We sail thousands of itineraries a year. We have hundreds of ships on those itineraries. And so occasionally, mistakes are made. We want transparency. We want to make certain we learn from mistakes so that we can never repeat them and that we can mitigate any future mistakes. We're not perfect, but what we measure ourselves on is continuous improvement and that we're not repeating mistakes and we've learned and mitigated going forward. So overall, our track record has been very good in the Caribbean and elsewhere. Doesn't mean we're not without mistakes. and we're not making excuses for the mistakes. We have to learn from them because, again, our highest responsibility and our top priority, therefore, has to be excellence in safety, environmental protection, and compliance.